Welcome to Face to Face, and today we're going to go to Argentina. Well, we're going to stay in New York, and we're going to speak with Ana Clara about the Mapuche community. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
And so you consider yourself a Mapuche?
Yes, my family is Mapuche, and okay. I have family in Argentina on the front lines of what's going on right now.
And so what I know a little bit more about the Mapuche situation in Chile, but you have more information about the situation in Argentina.
Yeah.
With a new government, Macri, it's complicated.
It's very complicated.
Yeah.
I mean, what's happening is very much like what's happening everywhere else with indigenous communities.
Mm-hmm.
The displacement and the violence from the government, and the disrespect, almost like they have no rights as citizens, even though they are. So, I mean, I know that's happening in all places of the world. Even here, we saw it in North Dakota. But in Chile and Argentina, there's a lot more violence, and it's very outright. The government has no fear in being exposed or anything because they are corrupt, and everyone knows it already.
Yeah. And so people have been arrested, or the land has been taken over, or because I know more the situation with like the Milagro Sala story.
Right.
So does this, the same way of doing business in some ways, or how is...
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, everything is done through violence there.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing seems to be able to... No one can talk it out or anything, because it's so far gone. The things that have been happening in the communities that are happening to the Mapuche people have been happening for centuries.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they were there before Argentina was Argentina.
So... Like the land issue, so the land is taking away from them?
Yeah.
And can you explain a little bit more what's happening, or people who have been displaced? Or?
So the displacement has a lot to do with the laws that Argentina has. In 1991, Benetton, the company owned by Luciano Benetton, he bought 2.2 million acres of Patagonian land in Argentina.
Oh, wow.
And a lot of it was Mapuche land. That's where we have been for centuries.
Uh-huh.
And there was no law in the Argentinian constitution that protected them, us. And in 1994 was the first time that there was a law.
Uh-huh.
And it provided protection for educational and cultural development of Mapuche children and Mapuche seniors and people all throughout the communities, except that law was never respected by anyone. It seemed so like minimal to a lot of people that no one really respected it. Benetton never gave up that land again. That land was theirs now, So that land remained under Benetton power for forever, and it still is technically their land. And then in 2002, I think there were a couple of occupations, which would be better called a recuperation of land, because they have been there the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a recuperation of land in Santa Rosa, which is in Chubut, so in the Patagonia. And because of that, the government in Chubut had to acknowledge them, and they were given a piece of land from Benetton. That land was not fertile, and they did not accept it. The plays that these people are making, the corporations are making, are purely out of greed and consumption, and kind of to like not pay attention to it, to put it aside, you know? So in 2006, finally, there was a law that passed that had a lot more protections for the people in these communities, in these LOFs.
And it was under Kirchner government?
It was under Kirchner, in 2006.
Yeah.
So one of the more progressive governments of Argentina, after many, many
years of
dictatorship and horrible, corrupt governments. That law had an expiration date of about 4 years, and since then has been reestablished and sanctioned again twice. So the reason that there have been so many mobilizations and protests and recuperations this past summer was because that law was about to be ineffective as of November 27th, 2017. So coming up, that law is no more. But because of all the movement that happened in Argentina and all the media coverage that it got, finally, that law is now re-sanctioned for another 4 years.
Ah.
Which is great, but it's so going to have to happen every 4 years.
That was a pressure from the community.
From the people, because the community, yeah. It wasn't just the Mapuche community.
Yeah.
It was a lot of allies. It was a lot of people that were finally understanding.
Okay.
And that had a lot to do with the new government, because there are a lot of people, liberal, neoliberal, progressive, leftist, everyone that is not far right is against this government.
Yeah,
this government is, you know, extremely corrupt.
So it's 4 years.
4 years, yeah, four
so
more years.
So it's not...
It's not great, but
yes,
I mean, it's great for right now, for the people, for the actual individual communities that were being displaced.
Okay.
Because people were already attempting to buy these lands away from these people, but it's not great for the, you know, people 4 years from now.
But from he opens the door to having you more and be able to do a prolongation of the time, or making definitive, or...
Yeah, I mean, it opened the doors to the conversation, at least. You know, before even Argentinian people
didn't
know.
Anything.
I mean, it's a lot like here too.
Yeah.
You know, the stereotypes are alive and well.
Yeah.
In classes, when they teach about the Mapuche people, they speak in past term as if these people weren't here anymore.
Yeah.
They speak in you live in teepees, and the same thing here.
Mm-hmm.
It's everywhere. It's the education that empowers people, and because people are, you know, social media actually helped a lot with the movements.
But I met with indigenous community in New York, I think it was 2 or 3 years ago. They were at the UN, and they were meeting in New York, and they said, this is the first time where we were able to do a network all over the world. So the indigenous community were able to coordinate and circulate the information from the indigenous from Africa, the indigenous from Asia, with enormous community. I mean, in Asia, the indigenous community is huge, and Europe, and South America, and America. So on the same time, then you have this attack on the indigenous community. You have also a big recognition. I know in Colombia they took a big part of the process on the peace process. It was a big chunk. And then in Bolivia, Evo Morales has been elected.
Yeah.
So you have also, and that's maybe why the fight it's so because the indigenous community is really taking power more than
Absolutely.
They were before. So.
Absolutely. I mean, the one thing that every single indigenous people have in common is displacement and colonization.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, since people seem to be waking up or something, people are talking more and more about decolonization and taking back our land, taking back our cultures. People are joining together because they realize that there are a lot of us. And like in anything, you know, there's strength in numbers, there's power in numbers. And when people come together, even if it is, you know, not literally together because these people live in different places, it starts a conversation.
Yeah, but they also, I mean, they're also the strongest community who can stand up because they work as a community.
Yeah.
So they can move as a community and say, where, I will say, in our lifestyle, we are all individual and we don't even know which community we belong to, and it's much more complicated to identify to a group of people and be able to say, well, I'm going to fight this one.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's where the strength of the indigenous community is. They value the common community to be able to work and know that if no one survives, I mean, if they cannot survive
without
by themselves.
Each other. Yeah, exactly.
So.
Yeah, I mean, in Argentina, it's very hard to, I mean, it's not very hard. It's actually very important. You know, the values are very indigenous. The indigenous values are very peaceful. They're nonviolent.
Mm-hmm.
I know the Mapuche people are extremely nonviolent.
Yeah, yeah.
So when you have a government coming in and shooting real bullets at people who are recuperating land, you have very minimal options there. Like, it's either stand back or die. And a lot of people are willing to die for this cause, which is great, but it's also scary because, you know, we're already in danger in Argentina, so, you know.
Yeah, Argentina is, Macri government, it's really,
there are,
it's very terrible. No, but I mean, it go beyond the rule of law. It go beyond the justice system. It go beyond. I mean, it's almost every news, and I get it's really. So what are the next step for the community or for the for the fight in different? Does this happen in different? It's mainly in the south of Argentina.
Yeah, mainly the south. I mean, this is the Mapuche people. Yeah. So there are about like 31 different indigenous peoples in Argentina.
Okay.
Owning a lot of land, not okay. owning, but a part of a lot of land in Argentina. But the Mapuche people are very south in the Patagonia, where, mm-hmm. where I'm from, and mm-hmm. the south of Chile,
yeah.
which is where there are also Mapuche people. So okay. next steps would be to try to keep the conversation alive. Mm-hmm. It's very hard. We have a very hegemonic media in Argentina. So, you know, everything is politicized, but in a very negative way.
Yeah.
So if you read an article about the Mapuche people, there's got to be like terrorists, you know, it's all in the same concept idea that's given to the people. Once the people start to educate themselves, start to go outside their comfort zones and listen and mm-hmm. learn from these people, mm-hmm. they'll understand what we need. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's kind of about educating ourselves, learning, listening, and kind of doing what they're asked of almost.
And that's a little bit why you came here today.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's important for people all over the world to know about what's happening. Mm-hmm. And it's very strange to think that, you know, this is happening, no one's heard about it. But it's also crazy to me that it's happening in other countries and I don't know about it. You know, I can be the most, you know, educated person on this topic, but there are still so many moments and
oh, in Myanmar right now, it's a million with Bangladesh, and they go to the poorest part of Bangladesh. So Bangladesh is already poor, but there are 500,000 people who just arrived to the, they were there a little bit before, but so it's a very complicated situation.
Yeah, I mean, displacement
And the Myanmar government doesn't want to recognize them. They were there for generation and generation. It's terrible. Terrible. So I wish you all the best for your work. Please keep us posted.
Let us know if you
need support in New York.
Okay.
And thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Marichuel.
Thank you. That was Face to Face. And please keep watching your news on Presenza.com. And hope to see you very soon again. Thank you.